Good afternoon, Central Library Building. Good afternoon, Central Library Building. You. I'm trying to connect you.
It's who? Oh, yes. Thank you. All the books that we've got in here belong to the people out there because they pay their rates for the library. You've got to be sure that you spend that money accurately. It's in the early 70s, libraries took a change from being just holier than thou, quiet please and don't speak. We became, librarians like to call themselves, cultural and educational centres. I think we have become that in the true sense of the word now. People have begun to realise that the information that they're seeking, as well as the recreation that they're seeking, is available in libraries.
This is a very good book.
I'm trying to find out how to pay. I really am.
Got some about Egypt.
About Egypt?
Yeah, because I've got to do some history homework
about Tutankhamun.
He was an Egyptian king. So he was first on the throne when he was 9 years old, but he died when he was 18. As when the people who found him did find him, he had a sort of cut in his leg which had been stitched up, and he had a walking stick. These wisdom teeth had just come through.
Well, David Whale, he's what we call our bibliographical services officer. He is one who takes care of the coordination of the material which is available throughout South Tyneside libraries.
Nobody earning can teach you how to select books for a particular place. Mm. And if I went from here to another authority, I would not be able immediately to select the stock for that place. Mm. You can evaluate books, you know, you can be taught through college and everything else to evaluate books, what to look for, what is a good book on the subject. But that doesn't teach you whether or not that book is needed in that library.
This is the list that comes to me as a copy with all the branches on, mm-hmm. and also centres, the books that they want to buy. Mm-hmm. So what I then do is make out an order card for each book. That then goes in the order files, which are like this. This is the official instructions to the supplier, seeing exactly what the list is.
Generally, they just ring in here, you know, all upstairs. Social services ring in quite a lot. Once or twice we've had doctors know there was the son and daughter calling. Uh-huh. And then I call out, hopefully within the next couple of weeks, and uh-huh. have a word with them, uh-huh. find out what sort of books they like, and we'll forward.
This is a gentleman who takes the books.
I remember one time there was a woman whose son. I think I'm writing, I must get this story right. I think it was her son who was in Australia whose favourite hymn, I think, was Onward Christian Soldiers. And our housebound service took a tape recorder into St Hilda's Church and recorded the choir singing Onward Christian Soldiers and gave it to the woman. And I heard the story of all of them sitting around the tape recorder crying while the tape recorder played on of Christian Soldiers. Yeah. But I find Geordies are very personable people. Mm. You know, they are, I mean, you hear a lot of people say that Geordies are friendly. Mm. I'll tell you they are. Certainly the people who come into the libraries are. They are very, and they do like you to speak to them.
What is it?
He's on
Bah. Bah. That's right.
Bah.
Yes, and of course children weren't really allowed in the adult parts, you know. I mean, you used to have sort of wooden benches just as you went into each department where they could sit.
remember sitting there every day when I
mean, it was, you know, they were very strict about, you know, sort of how quiet they had to be. And,
yes, it's not quiet the way it used to be.
So, I mean, that has changed a lot.
Hens? That is a sheep. A sheep? What did the sheep say? And what else did he say? No eggs here. Oh, dear. So you went to the stable and asked the horse. Hang on a minute, Craig. Horse, what did the horse say? No eggs here, Brian. Oh dear.
So many things in libraries now need to be speedier because people are demanding more from their libraries. But mechanisation's going to come. But when I come to the end of a talk, I always say to people, if you watch Star Trek, watch Captain Kirk on Star Trek, and they, you know, in comparison with the printed word, I'm talking about electronics then, before the end of every Star Trek programme, a pretty little blonde thing sashays on with Captain Kirk there sitting in his chair. And always, on, before the end of every episode, she comes on, holds out this box and gives him either a pen or a pencil, and he signs something. So there's somebody looking after the printed word. Even though you've got a spaceship that could talk back to you, you've still got the printed word.
Everybody's gonna jump for joy. Come on. All the pigeons gonna run to him. Come on without, come on within. You'll not see nothing like the mighty Quinn. Come on without, come on within. You'll not see nothing like the mighty Quinn. Let me do what I wanna do. I can't decide them all. Someone on everyone's toes. But when Quinn the Eskimo gets here, everybody's gonna wanna doze.